It's a great pleasure to be back in Winnipeg. I think the last time I was here was at the Palestinian Rights Symposium in 2018, and shortly prior to that to talk about Venezuela, as Radhika mentioned. And I've always been impressed by the level of militancy and progressivism and passionate commitment to social justice in this community. It's something that I think really stands out about Winnipeg, and it's a great pleasure to be here. I want to say at the outset, I'm quite impressed that so many of you have turned up this evening. I've had the experience prior to this evening and to this tour of having to deal with deplatforming. In 2016, I did a cross-country tour to support the Green Party of Canada's resolution in support of BDS. And as a result of some fierce advocacy on the part of those who support Israel, we were shut out of a venue in Calgary and managed to scrounge one up together at the last moment. And then yesterday in Toronto, we were also shut down, unfortunately, because OPSU in Toronto, the Ontario Public Service Employees Union, felt that there were security risks. And so we ended up having an impromptu gathering on a pub beside OPSU. But I have yet to experience a deplatforming that succeeded twice in one day. So this is the first time. We were canceled twice within the space, I think, of the last 24 hours. And nonetheless, all of you showed up. And I just want to applaud you all. Your commitment is amazing. I never would have imagined that we could assemble a crowd to deliver to those who tried to shut us down. We will not be silenced. First of all, we have a voice. We may or may not be right in this debate, but we deserve to be heard. And your efforts to deplatform us are, frankly, having the opposite effect of that you intended. You're drawing attention to our cause, and we thank you for doing that, although we know that that wasn't your ultimate objective. Ultimately, I think Canadians need very much to hear what we have to say, and anybody here this evening who wants to disagree with me vigorously, as long as you give me a reasonable opportunity to respond to whatever criticisms you may have, I welcome that. And at the end of the night, as a result of those criticisms, I may well find myself enlightened. So I welcome the debate.